Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create facade design in Revit. Here is my custom facade design. I will walk through with you together from start to finish. As you can see here, it's quite nice and quite realistic. Here I just open up for visualized style is the consistency. If I turn on for realistic, you will saw another different option for our facade design there. And there I got combination with my previous facade design. Here is my previous tutorial. I will put link in the description if you want to model how to model those kind of facade design here. And of course, I will give you a quick instruction. Basically, for this kind of facade, you can using your extrusion that combine basin with your void split and blank, and of course you can using masking and size also for this kind of facade. But today I just covering using our extrusion and our sweep plane to create those kind of facade. So I think it's pretty much for introduction. So let's speak into our project together. So I'm going to open up another project for create those kind of facade here. Just control and on my keyboard for shortcut key for new template. Then I just drop down finding for metric architecture template. Then I just hit OK. Once I done that, they will transform me to another page. Okay, alright guys, here I'm in Revit architecture template. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to create some floor first and create another level first. So basically I'm going to my sound elevation there, and of course for my previous project I will keep it reminding. And what I'm going to do next, I'm going to create another floor. The quick way to add that, you using array tool AR for array for shortcut key. Then I will make it 4 meter by 4 meter, make all our level 1, level 2, and level 3 is balanced. So I'm going to tie it out for 4, 4. Mean our level is from level 1 until level 5. Hit escape a couple times. Then what I'm going to do next, I'm going back to my open up my new 3D default. So basically when I'm working on Revit, I don't like this kind of elevation. So how could I hide that? I can select all like this, then right click on my cursor, then hide and view. And of course I can hide like this. Is just a hide thing, not a correct way to hide it. I want to hide this guy over there is correct way. I just tie VG on my keyboard for visibility graphic, then go to our annotation. Whatever you want to hide, you just drop down finding for can content. So I will finding for character L, because L is start from level, it's this guy over there. So then apply, then it's okay. Okay, as you can see now my elevation is gone. So I'm going to start from my top view there. Then go to our architecture tab, go to our floor. I'm going to start create floor first. Just draw it something like this, and I will make it for 20 or 12 meter, and make this guy over there is 14 meter. Hit escape a couple times, and of course I will assign a new material, or I don't need, I just hit finish because I don't want to waste time to assign for new material. So once I done that, I just select copy to clipboard, then align to select level, start from level 2 until level 4. I mean all of my level will be copying it. I turn on like this. As you can see here. So now what I'm going to do next, I'm going to create our facade design here over there. I'm going to create our facade design there. So go back to my 3D there. Then I will start from top view. Then go to our model in place. Then I will stand for category for generic model. Just hit OK. It's OK again. Once I done that, I'm going to create some extrusion first. Then just simply start like this, and I will adjustment, make it 4 meter, and make this guy over there for 2 meter. Hit escape. For extrusion, I will make it for 2 meter. Apply. Then I can assign for a new material as well. Create a associate family parameter. I will make it for material. Then it's okay. One I done that, I just finish up. Okay, so now I just got my solids only for solid. I will make it for 4 meter. Right, okay, so now I just got my solid extrusion only. So what I'm going to do next to create our facade. So I'm going to create tab, then go to void. Then we're using for void sweep blank. Then I will start a sketch pen. I need to set a work plan first basically. Then I will set for this corner, start from the right side. Then I will start draw it, just make it like this. Then hit escape a couple time. Then I just hit finish. Okay, perfect. Then I'm going to my modify and sweep plane again. Go to select profile 1, then go to edit profile. Then I will start from front view. I will just make it follow 4 meter like this. Hit escape. I just hit finish. Go to modify, sweep plane again. Select profile 2. Then go to edit profile. I will start from the... Okay, we just start the same portion. But this time I will make it on the center. Like this and like this, and again I will draw for rectangle, just make it for 2 meter. I will make it for 2 meter by 2 meter. Once I done that, I will select all, then go to move or MV for shortcut key. I will make it like this, then like this, then move again. Okay, once I done that, I will select all like this. Then I just hit delete. Then I just hit finish. Okay, so now it's nothing happened. I can go to my blank and finish up. As you can see, now I got my profile with my extrusion and my facade design already, my first facade. So now what I'm going to do next, I got assigned for material already. So I just hit finish. Okay, perfect. Now I'm going to select here. I will start from level, I think I will start from level 2. Then I'm going to move it. Then move it from here until here. And move it again to go inside. Make it like this. Then go to our front elevation, sound elevation, sorry. Discover there basically is too long already. Okay, sorry about that. Select all, SA, select all, then I will ungroup it. Then I will adjustment make it nicely. We just tidy up. Okay, then this guy over there, I'm going to move to level 2. Because basically our facade will be start from level 2. Okay, perfect. Then AR for array, I will start array from here until here and tie number 3. Hit escape a couple time. Then I can select all like this. Then AR for array, start array from here until here, and I will type it for number 4. Okay, perfect. So here will be delete because our facade is got 3 floor only. Then I'm going to my 3D again, as you can see here. So now what I'm going to do next is this kind of situation because I want to place here also. So I can select here like this, then ungroup on my facade design, then select here again. I need to ungroup again. Select here, then I will start from the right side here. Then CO for copy, start copy like this. Then hit aspect key on my keyboard for rotate my facade heat panel like this. Then I'm going to move it. Just move until here. Then we'll be start from top. Just want to make sure it's as everything is fine. As you can see here, you need to move more. So I'm going to move from here, until connected. Okay, I think here I need to move also. Just move it like this. Okay, perfect. Then AR for array. I will start array from here until here and tie numbers. Okay, the reason is coming out here because we never check properly on our property. AR for array. I need to start from here first. Let me see first. We could not, so I will be using for copy, select here, then CO for copy. Make sure you unconstrain and select take for multiple. I start from here until here. And let me see first, is it why what happened? We cannot, because I think because of the group, that's why we could not use that. Maybe we haven't ungroup yet. Let's try it out again. AR for array, I will start like this until here. Still the same situation. So how to do that? I'm going to select here, then ungroup, then CO for copy. I will start copy from here until here and copy another one. Then hit escape a couple of time. Then select our three guardian, 1, 2, 3, and copy and align to start from level 3 until level 5. It's okay. Then hit escape a couple of time. Change the sky over there to visualize style to hidden line. As you can see here, it's more already. So I'm going to delete this guy over there first. And V for move. Okay, that's it. When I start like this, and I can change my visualize style early. Graphic display option. We make it more, and the background will change as well. To gradient is apply hit finish. Okay, as you can see here, it's our facade design. The joining parts are quite nice. Basically, here I got tie out for the length is 12 meter, and this guy over there is 14 meter. That's why the joining connection is coming very well here. And of course, you can assign for new parameter for metric as well. Look back on my previous design here, as you can see here. And of course, I just remind you, if you want to create those kind of facade here, just check out my previous tutorial. I will put a link in the description. And of course, for the next tutorial, I will guide you how to create the awning here. Apply the awning here, just a very quick one. We just do that about 1 minute or 2 minutes only, if you know the trick. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. Thank you for joining me from start to finish, and I hope you got learned something new. If you like this tutorial, make sure thumbs up, like, and share to your friend. Thank you for watching, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice weekend. Thank you.